Welcome back. I'm Curtis Smith with the Northern Mailbag. We thank you for sending in your questions. It's really nice to have these, and we like to cover a variety. Even though we can't answer every question that comes in, we like to have a variety of questions. The first one is from Gloria in Las Lunas, who said at the nursery, she saw a ficus tree with a braided trunk, and she wonders how they did that. Well, here's an example of a ficus with a braided trunk. And what happened here is a lot of young trees were planted together. All the lower branches were trimmed off. And then they were just carefully braided together to create this look. As it gets older, these will fill in. You can see right here that it's already grafting itself together. And that's happening everywhere they cross. In time, it will just grow together. And you have this large, twisted, gnarled look, which is the braided ficus trunk. So Gloria, you can do it too, or you can go buy one just like this. And from Taos, we had Jack write and ask us, can I grow my miniature rose indoors all year? Now Taos is pretty cold, but the miniature rose is quite hardy. But you can grow it as a houseplant indoors, nice, pretty flowers. You need to clean it up and remove the spent flower buds or those that don't open. You can enjoy the little buds as they're forming. But you have to watch out for certain problems that are going to develop. Indoors, they seem to have some problems. One here is powdery mildew. If this is in an atrium or something, it stays quite humid. You may see powdery mildew, that white powder developing here, the distorted shape of the leaf. So that's something you'll watch out for. You'll have to deal with perhaps using a fungicide to help control that. Another thing that happens a lot indoors is that you'll get spider mites. You want to watch the underside of the leaves. You look for little tiny things that move around. Or you may find a webbing, very, very fine webbing. It looks more like lint than anything else. That would coat the leaves, maybe the stems. That'd be a sign of spider mites. That's an easy problem to solve just by washing it down the water. Take it to the bathtub and give it a shower. That's an easy way to control it, but wash the underside of the leaf as well as the top of the leaf. Indoors, you want to see that it gets adequate light. A window that gets only a couple of hours of sunlight a day is not going to be sufficient. You'll need to make sure it gets a lot of light. If it's direct sunlight for only a little while, put a sheer curtain in the window so that it diffuses that light, and so it gets less light when the sun's shining directly on it, more light through the rest of the day. And then just take care of it, prune it as it needs, and it can take a lot of pruning even now while you're growing the roses. If you wanted to cut this flower, go ahead and prune it back to the first five leaflet leaf like you would a normal rose. You could also, after it finishes flowering, prune it back to that point. And by pruning, you're going to keep it compact and also encourage new flowering. It's a really nice plant to have as a house plant, but it's one that also does require some winter. It's hardy, so it can survive outside. In a pot, it might freeze, but if you'll sink this in the ground or put it in a cool, but a place that doesn't get too cold through the winter, it's going to do well. But again, remember, it has to have some cold dormancy during the winter to do well. If you're going to grow it inside, you're going to have to watch it while it is inside, see that it gets enough light, that it doesn't have diseases and insects. And so you'll have to take care of it a little bit more than outside sometimes. But it is a plant. You can grow inside. It'll do well there if you take care of it. Thank you for asking. And Candace and Socorro ask us, do carnivorous plants really eat insects? Why? Well, let's look at some carnivorous plants here. We've got one that's called the Venus flytrap. And if we look carefully here, we can see a moldy fly in that trap. The fly has been eaten, is dead, and now there's just mold growing on it. And we see some others in some of the other traps in this plant. So these have been eaten, so yes, the plant eats the fly. And if we show you what happens here, if the fly were to fly in, the little trigger hairs in here, as we push it, it just closes up. And that's how it traps the fly. Then it has chemicals that steal the nutrients from inside the fly. In other words, it is eating the fly, taking minerals and nutrients from the fly for the plant. And that's because these plants grow in places that are very low in nitrogen. And the insects have protein in them. The protein contains nitrogen. So they're eating the insects to get the nitrogen they need to grow. So the Venus flytrap does indeed eat flies. And let's look at a pitcher plant. It's a different kind of carnivorous plant. There's one right here. It's called a purple pitcher plant. It works differently. It doesn't have a trap. At the end of the leaf, it has a pitcher, which is a hollow tube that holds a liquid. That liquid has a smell that attracts insects. The insects fall into that. And on the inside, there are hairs that are pointing downward. And so as the insect tries to come up, it can't climb back up. It's stopped by the hairs that are pointing down. So it stays there in that liquid, and that liquid then digests the insect. And again, the plant can eat the insect and provide the food that's lacking in the environment for the plant. Now, this is a very small one. The Venus flytrap's another very small one that grows well in a terrarium-type environment. But there's some larger ones that are nice for greenhouses. If you've got a greenhouse, you probably have some insects. So let's look at the larger pitcher plant growing in the hanging baskets here. And this is the larger pitcher plant, much larger. It also collects insects in a fluid at the bottom here. It eats the insects, but it's attached to a bigger plant in a hanging basket in a greenhouse. So it can eat the plants, the bugs that bother the plants in the greenhouse. Candace, yes, there are plants that eat insects, and they do it because they need the minerals that are missing from their environment that the insects can provide.